great.
She returned to competitive skating last year after being away from the ice for 4 years. Here is 28-year-old Kathaleen Kelly Cutone.
She's skating to the music of Phantom of the Opera.
I'm happy to say she's a graduate of Harvard, as well as being interested in the profession of law.
And she is now an attorney.
And she's also married to Butch Cutone.
About how difficult it must have been to make that return last year. She finished 11th at these national championships, and to continue competitive skating after being off for 4 years.
But that was a better placement than she had before she went to college. She's a very talented lady.
Very organized, apparently, to be able to fit in practice and on the ice and practice law at the same time.
Loop, double loop.
The same short program since 1988, and this was choreographed by Paul McGrath, who passed away from cancer.
Nice position. She was one of the few skaters to hold that first position for a substantial number of turns.
Very nice.
This was an excellent combination spin. Excellent.
Nice job.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And you see, 28-year-old skater and attorney, Kathaleen Kelly Cutone.
And this double axel, now look at the legs here. She gets very nice tight turns in there, but then doesn't unhook in time, isn't quite far enough around, is leaning too far, and of course falls. And this combination spin is very interesting. Back position, the back is quite nice there. And the two arms going forward, they're not lazily resting on her knee, and this kind of a position is really tough to do and do well and fast. Our slow motion is not showing quite how fast she is going. Very effective.
I thought the axel was nice.
Well, Kathleen has recently been working with a couple of coaches who can skate themselves. Mark Mitchell. Yeah, he captured a silver medal in the 93 championships here, and five-time Swedish champion Peter Johansson.
For required elements.
And she's looking at her scores for required elements.
4.2, 4.0.
Well, there were a lot of problems with those required elements, and that causes this position. She's not in contention here, certainly for a medal, but she's a very refreshing person to have in this competition.
She competes in this competition because she really enjoys skating and the challenge of competing.
And there's no chance that she will make an Olympic team. And doesn't that make it nice?
Mm-hmm.
4.5, 4.7, 4.7.
And now, remarks for presentation ranging from 4.3 up to 4.7.
4.3, 4.6, and 4.6.
So a look at the current standings after the short program of the ladies' competition. Michelle Kwan is in the lead. No surprise there. Tanya Kwiatkowski right now in second place. And Nicole Bolbeck has made one of those top three spots. And, of course, the top three after the overall competition move on to the world team. And the fourth member of our crew right now, Leslie Visser, has Nicole Bobek. Leslie?
Terry, she was sort of skating's Willis Reed, limping through an injury. First of all, how is your ankle? How was it out there?
It hurt pretty bad going through the program, put a lot of stress on it, and I just tried to fight through it, and I did all right.
People didn't know what to expect from you coming into this. What did you expect out of the short program?
I'm not sure really myself. My main goal was just to go out there, push through it, and just do it, and whatever I decide to do, just go for it, and that's what I did.
Are you disappointed with third, or you feel still in the hunt?
I still feel in the hunt. It doesn't bother me that I'm in third at all. You know, just the fact that I went up there and I gave my 100% makes me feel good about myself.
That you do. Best of luck in the long program. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Leslie. So it comes down to the free skate tomorrow night. You can